So, I'm just gonna give you Sharona.
When I was younger, so much younger than today, I never needed help in any way. But these days, I'm not so self-assured, because I live with a deep secret. All of my life, I felt I didn't belong here. I felt there was something wrong with me. I felt that I didn't matter. I felt I didn't have a purpose. I felt unworthy. I felt unvaluable. And then when I was 19 or 20 years old, I was diagnosed at that time with manic depression, what is now known as bipolar. And I didn't tell anybody because I had such a deep pain and shame for being me. I felt if I told somebody, my family, my friends, that somehow they would use that against me to show how unworthy and that I did not belong here. However, at the same time, I saw something that changed my life. Star Wars. Da, 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 da. And I know at that moment, I was meant to be a Jedi Knight. Jedi in training. And as all Jedi in trainings, a Padawan, all alone, I decided to do what I needed to do to build the skills up to become a Jedi Knight. I took fencing. I meditated. I also decided that I needed to learn all kinds of skills. So I did all kinds of jobs because otherwise I would get bored. So I became a carpenter, a gardener, a security guard. I became a teacher, a dancer. Yet inside, I still didn't feel like I belonged. I still felt that somehow it wasn't enough. I wasn't enough. I'm not enough, I'm not pretty enough, I'm not smart enough, I'm not enough. And I went on to school and learned more things and to do and do and do and do and try to cover up the pain within me. Fighting every day, should I stay, should I go? To be or not to be? And then 5 years ago, even though most of my life, without any medication, I managed this, all of this, alone. And yet 5 years ago, my life started unraveling in ways that I'd never experienced before. And I entered that cave where Luke meets Darth Vader. And very slowly, I started to go back into that cave, further and further back, back, beyond the backwaters of hell. Back, 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 until I was up to the very back, and there was a box. And I got into the box, into that corner. And then February of this year, 3, 2, 1, I was in a crisis center, in the middle of a crisis, talking to crisis counselors. I didn't think I would ever come out, because I knew that for me, this felt like the end. And then very slowly, with the help of therapy, with the help of my medical team, with the help of my friends, and a few friendly members, I slowly made my way up, walking toward the mouth of the cave. One step, one breath, one heartbeat, one moment at a time. Because recovery is not linear. It's a spiral dance that has ebbs and flows, and the thoughts of to be or not to be, to stay or to go, still here with me. But now I'm learning that I can rebuild my life, finding work, buying a new hybrid car, making sure my house is safe for me and my cat Squishers. I am still a Jedi in training, still a Padawan all alone, all one. I am what I am, and that's all that I am. I am enough. I am.